Welcome back, dear children. Till now you have studied about classification of plant, classification of plants, again two types, that is cryptogams and phanerogams. We are studying now cryptogams, and yesterday you have studied about thallophyta, correct? Thallophyta, you have to revise what thallophyta are as well as by heart the names of thallophyta. These are all algae. Algae means they are found in water or either a large amount of moist place, wherever good moisture, or if the water is settled anywhere or stagnant anywhere, you will find algae grown over there. So all these algae are included in thallophyta. Their body is thallus. Thallus means ribbon like flat. Now we are going to study again a cryptogam, second division, that is bryophytes or bryophyta. So the division bryophyta, here you will find this moss, all the types of moss. Moss means where they find moisture, they can grow on the bark of the tree, they can grow on the walls, or you will find them on the grass. So these are the moisture loving as well as shade loving plants. So bryophyta, these groups, we call them as amphibians. Why they are amphibians? Because when their reproduction stage is there, that time they require water, they require large amount of moisture. Okay, so we'll study, you will find this type of moss grown now as rainy season has started. This is a right time that we have started studying about this lesson. So you will find moss grown, different types of moss are there, and they are very beautiful. If you take a magnifying lens, you will find, see, this type of reproductive organ coming out from their body. Okay, so these are called as spores. So let's start studying and see, living creature, but very beautiful. This is green. They are autotrophic. They are cryptogams, that is non-flowering plants, as well as these are called as bryophytes. Okay. See, here you will find this type of moss everywhere grown. Okay, so the tree, you will find moss growing under the tree as well as wherever the moisture is in large quantity, you will find this type of plants. The outgrowth which comes out from it, it is a reproductive organ. Okay, reproductive thing which can give out spores, not flower. It is not a flowering plant. So now this is the further stage of algae. From this stage or from this division, you will find the plants have roots. You can see roots like thing, stem like thing, and leaves like thing. But you cannot tell that they are actually the roots, stem, and leaves. But they look like. So these are false. No, not actually the roots, not actually the stem, and not actually the leaves. Okay, so just you have to observe now in the surrounding. After some days, those moss or either these bryophytes, algae, they will start appearing on the ground. So you have to observe them very carefully. These reproduced with the help of spores, egg like substance or tiny particles which are given out from the body of this organism or this plant. Okay, you could see the rhizoids. These root-like substance are called as rhizoids, but they don't work like roots. Okay, they have tubular system. Tubular system means to absorb the thing from the surrounding, but this only helps for support. Okay, only helps for growth. So these are called as rhizoids. You will find this thing, this capsule like on the plant. These are the sporangium. Okay, this capsule contains spores, and below that which appears from the plant to help the capsule to come out from the plant body, that is called as stalk. And further down you will find green color part. These are the leaf like structure, but you cannot call them actually as leaves. Okay, so these are leaf like part, and below for support these root like part we call it as rhizoids. Okay, so the green color, whatever you could see, these are leaf like parts. Below root like, these are called as rhizoids. From the body of the plant, an outgrowth is given out. Okay, stem like, but it is not stem, it is called as stalk. And on the stalk there is a capsule, and this capsule holds spores. Okay, these spores will get matured and get ruptured out from the capsule. They will fall down on any of the thing or on the ground and grow into a new plant or new organism. Okay, now these plants require, or these bryophytes require, substratum. Substratum means a fixed support for support to grow, for their growth. It can be stone, it can be bark of the tree, or it can be any hard substance. So the characteristic of bryophytes are they consist of mosses and liverworts. Liverworts you will find here like Funaria, okay, and Marchantia. It looks like liver, so it is called as liverworts. They are found in moist, damp, humid and shaded localities. So they love these moist place, damp place. That means a large amount of moisture or water is contained over there. But they don't grow in flowing water or stagnant water, but wherever large amount of moisture is there, or as well as shade. Bryophytes live in soil but are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. They reproduce by the male gamete and the female gamete. Male gamete and female gamete, that means male egg and female egg for the reproduction. So for this thing only they are called as amphibians, amphibians of plant kingdom. Why amphibians? They require water also, as well as they require land also. Completely they cannot grow into water, as well as they cannot depend completely on dry land. So bryophytes, they do not have actually roots, stem or leaves. So true roots, stem or leaves are not there. So they are more differentiated than algae. They are one step further than that of algae. Algae doesn't have anything, no, neither root like part, no stem or no leaf like part. Their body itself is whole green in color. Okay, whole body contains chlorophyll. So they look like a thallus, that means flattened substance or flattened organisms, and can be prostrate or erect. They can be straight, erect, standing erect. They are attached to the substratum by unicellular or multicellular rhizoids. Okay, single cell rhizoid or many cell rhizoid. See here, like your textbook, the diagram, Funaria and Marchantia. See the parts of the plant, and you have to draw this diagram, label the parts. Learn to draw neat diagrams. Okay, so this is a homework for you today, as well as you have to learn the characteristic of bryophyta, learn and write. Next division is the pteridophyta. We have learned first division, that is telophyta, second division, that is bryophyta. Now the division pteridophyta, it is again an advanced stage of bryophyta. You will find these type of plants near your well. Now, wherever there is a large amount of moisture, it is usually called as fern plant. And we have this in our school. Near our school entrance, this fern plant is there. Okay. So, fern, different types of ferns are there, or pteridophytes are there. But their appearance is same. Some of them have small, tiny leaves, leaf-like structure. Or some have very flattened and big leaves. Here from this division itself, now you can differentiate the plant into root, stem and leaves. So pteridophyta, these plants from this group have well developed roots, stem and leaves, and they have separate tissues for conduction of food and water, as we have arteries and veins for conduction of blood as well as our food substance. Same way, plants also have tissues. Plants also have conducting vessels. Okay, so these are called as xylems and phloems. From this stage or from this division, the plant starts their advanced stage. They do not bear flowers, but these plants are non-flowering plants, so they do not bear flowers also, no fruits also. They reproduce with the help of spores. Spores are formed on their body, so these spores helps them for reproduction. Example, ferns, Neprolephis, Marsalia, Teres, Adiantum, Equisentum, Selaginella, Lycopodium. These are the names of scientific names of those fern plants. These plants reproduce asexually by spore formation, or they can reproduce sexually by zygote formation. So they also can reproduce sexually by zygote formation. Sexually means they have different male and female gametes. Okay, that can be on the same plant or that can be from the different plant. Okay, so they have a well developed conducting system. Conducting system means to carry the food and water to every part of the plant body. So here you could see the spores which are formed on the back side of the leaf. Got that? These spores becomes mature. As they are small, they will look like this. You could see. And as they grow up, they will become big and big. And then they will rupture out. This capsule will rupture out. Spores will fall down on the ground, or either they will be carried anywhere with the help of wind or water. And then a new organism will be developed. Okay, so these are different types of species of fern. And even though they are different types, they bear different types of spores. You could see these spores look different from each other. Okay, and these are, no, they don't have any never ending. They will show you greenery and greenery everywhere. So observe these type of plants around you. Collect it. Now, as soon as the spores falls down, you will find new plant comes out from it, new organism comes out from it. See how it will look like, this new organism or new plant, new pteridophytes from appearing out from the spores. See how it looks like. No, round, and the leaf will come out. Same like a small baby in the mother's womb, small embryo, no, embryo in the mother's womb, and then hands and legs developed. Same way for the plants also, for these plants also. Okay, these are different types of pteridophytes which you could see around you now in this rainy season. Now you'll find different types of these ferns. See, inside your well or on the wall of the garden, or gadga you call, na? Chira's wall is there, or on the house or on the mud, no, wherever they find good humid place, moist place, they will start growing there if their spores are fallen there. So observe these different types of ferns. Okay, and every fern will have these spores in one or two form. Okay, you will find this fern, you could see here, this fern is having spores, black color spots, adiantum. These are called as adiantum. Try to classify this. Okay, till today you have to study about the pteridophytes, bryophyta and pteridophyta. Okay, take care, write and study.